Chris Hallberg is running for the United States Senate. 5 minutes. Welcome, Mr. Hallberg.
All right, thanks. It's great to be here. And you know what? I have been here all day.
6 inches, sir.
6 inches, thanks. I have been here all day, and I wouldn't have had it any other way. And it's great to be with you. It's been great to have been visiting with you. You know what? You haven't been here all day just warming your seats, correct? I mean, you're here for a reason. You're here to defend this country. You're here to protect this great Constitution we have and the liberties that we have. And so as such, I think I have to say right out of the box, you're not here just to warm these seats. And so there's a process we have. And I want to say, I'm here. I'm abiding by the endorsement. The endorsement's important. Woo! Here's the thing. Other people are going to tell them, I'm doing this all for the party. And by the way, I would love your endorsement, but I'm going to the primary. I don't care what you're going to do. Here's the reality of Minnesota politics, the way it's worked in our party historically. Without exception, except for Arne Carlson, those with enough history will remember what happened in that strange election. The only way we win as Republicans is we get behind that candidate early in the race, we endorse him, and we stick behind him. That's the secret. So I'm here to tell you that I am the strongest conservative that's electable in this race. And so I'm working hard to get to be known. I'm known up in northeastern in Minnesota, where I'm a county commissioner up there. But just a couple issues, a couple facts out here. Twice I've been at the top of the polls among the candidates up against Al Franken. Last year I was at 10 points. Now I'm closing, I'm within 8 points. The secret of this race about electability is we gotta move out of the metro area where we get the Republican strongholds. We need those. But unless we start to take some of greater Minnesota and get some of those Democratic districts over to us where they got the Reagan Democrats, we're gonna lose again. And in my district, St. Louis County, I'll tell you, we're gonna beat Al Franken. I'm from St. Louis County there. He beat us with 22 points. Can you imagine that? 22 points. So the issue is, we have to win that area. I come to you as what I call a solid constitutional conservative. As a military man, I was the last in this race. I waited till my military retirement. I've done 25 years in the military, and I believe it's important to send a senator to Washington, D.C. that understands the military. And there's several reasons behind this, and I think we can look at what's going on in the Ukraine right now. And so, you know, it's easy. You're going to hear a lot of people on both sides of the aisle. They're pounding their chests. They say we have to get in there. But you need a person with enough experience that can look at this and say, question the generals when they're making the decision. And I have the credibility here that an Al Franken wouldn't have on this matter. The other thing I understand is there's been kind of this saying that we're not at war, we're at the mall. 1% of our people are serving. But I realize the tremendous cost that's going on there. We have issues coming back of suicides, mental health. We need to help our soldiers and work there. We also have to get away from this phase of nation building. And so we have to look at, thank you. We have to look what is the best interest of the United States. And that's the bottom line. Quickly, what my three issues are is this. And you know, I'm a military man, and what we say in the military is stay in your lane. When you don't stay in your lane, you get outside the lane and you start worrying about other people, that's where you have casualties. That's where people get killed. And so what we need in Washington, D.C. is to follow that Constitution and honor what the federal government's role is. Yes. And to me, what that is, it's national defense, protection of our citizenry both here and abroad, and securing the borders. The problems we have arose because we haven't followed the Constitution. We have the $17 trillion debt because we have people like Senator Franken that want to bring us in everything but what the role of the federal government is. Look at Affordable Care Act. That is not the role of the federal government. It should be at the state issue and best free markets. And the other issue is Common Core. It's absolutely terrible. And I stand before you as an equal opportunity criticizer. Because, you know, under Common Core is terrible, but it was equally bad under Bush with no child left behind, right? And so I'll finish up is that we cannot, don't buy into this fact that, listen, the only way that we're going to win this race is by sending a purple candidate, a Democrat light to Washington, D.C. I'll tell you what, that's a recipe for continuing on with the same old, same old. So here you got a candidate, and I'm a solid conservative, and I've shown that I'm within 8 points of Al Franken, and I can take the area up in northeastern Minnesota. I know you're going to deliver it down around the metro, and I'm going to be working in the metro. I want to finish with this. You know, we've gotten into the era of Broadway, Hollywood politics, right? And it's all kind of American Idol out there. And what has gotten to be now in our government the four most important qualities for running for the U.S. Senate? You know what they are? To be tall, dark, handsome, and a millionaire. Well, you're not going to have that, but what you're going to find in this campaign is if you endorse me, and this is what they know about me in northeastern Minnesota, because my district's blue-collar Reagan Democrats, where Obama got 70% and I got 60% in the re-election, is Chris Dahlberg is not a show horse. He's a workhorse. You put me as your endorsed candidate, and I'm going to take it to Al Franken, and I'm the guy that can beat Al Franken in November. Thank you much.